Einstein says if we knew what we were doing, it wouldn't be called research. When I try something and a project just completely fails, which sometimes happens, there's nothing wrong with that. In fact, the more something fails, often the more I can learn from it. Some friends and I were working on a design competition project based on having students develop things that can help soldiers survive longer in the field. And so they had requested a piece of equipment that could haul you up a rope really, really fast, just like Batman. So that thing was not very easy to build. We spent the whole first 4 months trying to build it, designing, testing things out in the lab, really hoping it works. It's about 3 in the morning, and we all just want to go home, but we finally got the thing together for the first time ever. So if you can imagine, it's kind of like a power drill, but you wrap a rope through it, attach the device to a climbing harness and pull the trigger, it pulls you up the rope super fast. And we're dying to try it. You've just been working so hard, you're really hoping it's gonna work. So we took it to a stairwell on campus. We were smart enough not to try to haul ourselves up on the first try. We figured, now if it doesn't work, we don't wanna get dropped on the ground. So we took about 8 water jugs out of the lab, tie them all together, and tie those to the rope that the device is on. Now we pull the trigger, and for a split second it works. It jerks them up in the air at about 10 feet per second. It's yanking these things upward, story by story, up into the stairwell. We were pumped that it was gonna work. We had no idea that it would be that fast. And then the fixture point broke. And 4 in the morning, 8 5-gallon buckets of water come crashing down. Biggest crash noise you can ever imagine. But the exciting part was, despite the fact that those 8 water bottles crashed down and almost broke the elevator, dumping water everywhere, we could see that it was going to work. So did we go back home and sleep? No, we went right back into the lab and kept working on it all night because we wanted it to work so bad. I figured out how it failed, but this part worked. Let's tweak a couple parameters, let's change things up a little bit. We spent a lot of time going through many different iterations to build what would become the Atlas Power Ascender. And it's out there saving lives.
An Organative has invented a device that could help in high-risk rescue situations.
Nate, you were telling me that the Army uses these right now.
Yeah, we actually have a number of devices in the field right now, and it's used in combat search and rescue, helicopter extraction.
I have never had a project work on the first try. When I try something, the purpose of solving the problem is to figure out something I didn't know. So, of course it's not going to work right. I don't know yet how it's going to work. You've got to build it, and you've got to try it. And every time, it works a little better, and pretty soon, you've got something brand new that could change the world.